Hey, Dr. Weaver here. Just want to let you know that we're going to go over digestion distress. All right, I talk about this in my book, The No More Meds, and it's on page 60. We're going to talk about the pyloric valve, but before we get into the pyloric valve and why we do it, we're going to discuss on apple cider vinegar, on how much I love apple cider vinegar, ACV is what I call it, or also known as liquid gold. It is so good for your digestive system. So if you're having acid reflux, or if you're having some digestive issues, apple cider vinegar is a way to go. Start slow though. Maybe 1 to 2 teaspoons, add it with some water on an empty stomach. Now, every morning I do this, and I also add my vitamin C, and I add a little bit of cinnamon, add a little cayenne pepper, and that's my little shot every morning to help not just my sinuses, but to help my digestive system. Like I said, it's liquid gold. It's good for a lot of good things. But one thing that I do notice with kids and adults is that we do not get enough fiber. So I'm going to discuss on how to get the pyloric valve to work properly, because the pyloric valve is, it gets stuck when we don't get enough fiber. So there is fiber capsules that you can take daily. There's also some good old powder, but I know kids don't really like taking these things. This is great for mostly adults, but just like my elderberry syrup, there is a great product called Ready, Set, Go. And I love the name of it because it actually makes it ready, set, go. So I love the product Ready, Set, Go. And the reason why is because it has wonderful psyllium seed, wonderful psyllium husk to help basically push on the pyloric valve. For people that are constipated, for people that are having gas or bloating, you're not getting enough fiber. Actually, the recommended dosage is between 19 to 31 grams. So average is about 20 for kids. And then I say for adults, we need 30 grams of fiber. And let me tell you, we're not getting enough because we're not eating enough fruits and vegetables. And that's another thing, is if you're not eating enough fruits and vegetables, you got to take some kind of digestive enzyme, because that helps break down the food in the stomach. Just like I mentioned before on the apple cider vinegar, what it does is, and what it's designed to do, is to help break down the food so big food particles don't get through the stomach to the small intestine. The bigger the food particles get through, that means more bacteria, especially bad bacteria, can leak and get really full in there, make you feel bloated. So if you feel bloated, that means you have a problem. Take some digestive enzymes to help break down the food, take some extra fiber to help push the food through, and today we're going to give you an awesome tip to help you get your pyloric valve working properly so you don't have to need a bunch of different things to keep your immune system and keep your digestive from being distressed. All right, so now we're going to use the pyloric valve exercise. And what that is we're going to find her belly button, and then we're going to go about 2 inches above that. Now, everybody's is different because everybody is different. Everybody's anatomy is a little bit different. But what we're looking for is about 2 inches, and we want to do like a circle. Oh, yeah, there it is. I can feel it right away. Of course, I've felt thousands of these, and I know this is probably your first time feeling your own, but you'll actually feel like a little bubble right in here, and it's really hard on her, actually. And this is a very sensitive area for a lot of people, and so you want to start really slow, and basically what I'm doing is a circular motion to kind of start with. And again, the pyloric valve is in between the stomach, which is on your left side, and it's a valve that helps push the food through to the small intestine. So all we're doing is actually doing a massage technique to help her food get through the stomach to the small intestine. Now, you don't want to do this right after you eat. You want to do this about 3 to 4 hours after you eat. So the best time to do this is at night. And usually when I tell patients to do this is when they've already done what I call the deep breathing exercises, because the diaphragm is right here, and the diaphragm is a wonderful muscle to help digestion distress. And to do the deep breathing exercises will activate the diaphragm to help the pyloric valve before you actually even do the exercise. So again, what we're going to do is a circular motion right in here, just kind of warm up that area. Now, what I've already done for her is I have taken fennel, like I described earlier. I put 30 drops of fennel in this bottle, and the rest was a carrier oil, which I use with fractionated coconut oil. And this is a really handy, wonderful little roller bottle that you can kind of roll. Now, what I like to do for kids, because you know I like kids, and not that I don't like adults, but adults like this too, is I just kind of just do a smiley face on their belly, just right there. So just a smiley face right in here. And you're just really trying to get the fennel in there really good. And this really will help the massage. Now, I am not lifting up her shirt, but you would want to do this. You want to get the essential, obviously, not on her shirt. You want to get it into the skin. But then when you're doing the valve yourself, you want to do it on your shirt. And I'm going to tell you why, because a lot of times you're not going to be able to have your spouse or your parent do this for you. You're going to have to do this yourself. So in order to do this yourself, and this is actually the first time this patient's done this, so she is learning along with you guys. So she is taking a 1 pound weight, and after she works right in here, and she can just kind of do a circular motion, she's going to help push her stomach into that valve just like that. Just about that much pressure. Again, this is not supposed to hurt, but the first few times, and if you have a lot of comfort with digestion, it will be sore. Be patient with yourself and do about 3 to 5 minutes, not 35 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes on doing this. And what that will do, again, you're never supposed to bloat in this area, but a lot of people have what we call SIBO, which is small intestinal bacteria overgrowth. And the bacteria builds up here because, again, those food particles are too big and they get lodged. Now, a lot of patients ask me, why does my pyloric valve get blocked? What causes the blockness to happen? Stress. Stress causes it. So when we're under a lot of stress and we get the sympathetic nervous system to go really nuts, what that does is cut off that valve so we can flight. We can run and get away from that bear that's attacking us, and we forget about our digestive system. So in order to get this whole digestive system working, the first thing to do is take some deep breaths. You know, I love my deep breathing, and that helps your parasympathetic with your nervous system to relax, rest, and digest. So that's why it's important to do your deep breathing and then do your pyloric valve and get that stomach and get that valve working like it's supposed to. Now, another thing I want to share with you guys is the ileocecal valve, and it's right down in here. And how I like to show you here is like you take your belly button and it's like right where your pelvis is, and you're almost like drawing just a diagonal, and it's right in between that area towards her shoulder here. And so we can also work that area, and that's another valve that comes between the small intestine and the large intestine, right close to your appendix, and it causes a lot of issue, and a lot of people have pain there as well. And what we see in thermography is either one or two or both valves are not working properly. And you can also work that same direction. You're going to go in small circular motions, and then you're actually going this direction, just like this, to help your digestive system. All right. I hope this was very helpful for you guys and that you won't have any more digestion distress. Now, this is an extra little bonus. Who likes bonus material? I always love my bonus material. So what I did with this is I actually put sweet fennel in it. You don't want to use peppermint because a lot of people think peppermint is really good for digestion. But it is. But if you have acid reflux, it actually can cause problems with the pyloric valve. So don't use that. But I love fennel, and it smells fantastic. It's got a really neat, like, licorice smell. It's fantastic. And what it can do is actually help your digestion distress. People, again, that have constipation, gas and bloating, digestive problems, fennel is your friend. Hey, Dr. Weaver here. Just wanted to let you know, if you have not subscribed to my channel, now's the time to do it, because I am hot and I'm excited about sharing some information to you. Every week, I'm going to be giving you more and more information. So if you haven't subscribed, now is time to subscribe.